like he's making a trail of ice.
Oh, a trail of ice?
I met Liam just before his second birthday, and I was asked to see Liam because there were some concerns with how his motor development was progressing, and they were having a lot of difficulties with tightness in his muscles that were interfering with what you would typically see a child his age able to do.
Liam's cerebral palsy affects his body functions. He has dyskinetic movements, so he can't grasp things, he can't feed himself, change himself, or toilet himself. So we have to do that for him.
Okay, so while this is happening, guess what's happening over here?
As part of seeing Liam, we saw that he was this bright young boy who was, his eyes were just full of life, and he's wanting to communicate and express what he wanted. And he was really struggling and frustrated that he couldn't express what he wanted to do, and was really having troubles with moving. So that fits well within how our team works with kids, and we are hoping that we could provide some therapy and options to help his motor development along.
Hi, Liam!
Any kind of technology that's assistive technology, whether it be power mobility, communication devices, tools for computer access, environmental control, or even tools to help you do better at school for literacy and math, we do here. And so we have a multidisciplinary team that has a lot of expertise and specialties. So we all work together to put together these very complex assistive technology systems for clients just like Liam.
What we're trying to do is figure out what's important for Liam and what's important for his father in his development, and how can we help them reach the goals that they have.
He's very independent minded, so I knew the minute that we got access to our brain control interfacing that he would be someone that we wanted to talk to about that. Basically, it's taking EEG signals from our brains, and it is interfacing with a very special computer system and software. The computer then converts those signals and sends them to the software, which then allows us to control things. So, for example, it's like thinking about moving allows us to move a remote control car when we can use the special interface.
Run over your dad's hand.
He just likes to watch my son and my daughter play video games because he can't play. But with this new equipment, now he can be part of it. So to watch him play his first video game, he was so happy and ecstatic. It was great. Now mostly that stuff is made for adults, so it's in the younger stages of it for children, and they're just learning how, Liam's helping them learn how to make it more accessible for children and, you know, at a younger age.
We've heard a parent say that, you know, for my son coming and to use BCI, that's their leisure activity, that's their extracurricular activity, where their siblings or friends go to dance or go to hockey. My son gets to come play a video game, whereas at home that isn't a possibility right now.
He's so happy when he does it. He's like, Dad, you see what I just did? And I was like, yep. And he's just so happy that he feels so independent when he does these things as well.
We can imagine a future where Liam could use BCI to help drive his wheelchair, for example, or as he goes through school and completes his education, you know, when he's ready to move out to his own place, he might be able to use BCI to turn the lights on and control his home, and then maybe to get in his wheelchair or other way of getting to work and control that to getting work, and BCI may be an important part of whatever profession he chooses.
The more independent he becomes with technology, who knows, he can do anything.
Whoa, push, yeah!
Smart home technology and computer access technology can be the difference between living potentially in an independent living situation or living in a place where you need a lot of care. So that's really the reason that we do what we do, is we want people to live as independently with the greatest quality of life, doing the things that they want to do.
We want to be able to know that we're providing the very best opportunities and care for everybody who comes to trust their care to a provider here at the Glenrose.
A lot of the stuff is really costly, and for us to give our patients those things that they want, we really need people to continue to step forward and help us out to do that.
A lot of kids, you know, They don't have proper mobility or proper ways of doing things adequately, and the Glenrose provides those missing pieces to make kids' lives a lot easier. So for us, it's quite important. Liam has come a long way from being in an incubator. He can do so much more by himself because of the Glenrose.